for the sake of shorthand, I would say the studio system and what can loosely be described as the independent sector. And I don't mean the codependent studio-ish type of sector. I mean the truly independent sector that I'm used to. And the basic difference is this: when you are working on these huge studio films, you have to remember that the creativity happens months ago, sometimes even years ago. When you come to spend $200 million, you don't leave anything to chance. There's a checklist when people go, it's going to be done exactly like that, and we're going to show you the reel of how it's going to be done. They show it to you, and then you go and you do it. When you are working with nobody looking over your shoulder and very little budget, and you're in a location, and you wrote down a scene which says bright sunlight, and it's raining, and you have the location until 6 o'clock, and there's no way you're going to be able to come back. You have to be creative right now. You have to think, and you have to make a decision. You can't just sit around and wait for the weather to change. And that is a really, really big difference. I mean, that working in one of those systems might suit somebody very well. Working in another might suit another very well. But there's no reason to believe that if you're happy in one system, you would be happy in another.
There is a European style of filmmaking. In America, we had one of our earlier guests this week was Anne Carey, who you made fun of Sucker.
Yes.
And that's the kind of film that would be made in Europe.
Absolutely. But that's why I say it. So the geographical boundaries are misleading, I think. I mean, it's much more, there's a sort of, it's more a question of sensibility and, of course, about money. Because sensibility brings with it a kind of, you know, price ceiling. I think if you are looking for colleagues and you're feeling hidebound in your own geographical space, don't forget that there's a wide planet out there and you'll probably find colleagues on the other side of the world.
Well, we have a final clip which is from the Michael Clayton at the end of the film, and when that's finished, I think it'd be nice if the audience could ask you some questions. So could we have the final clip, please?
How'd it go in there?